Welcome back to another Terranscapes video. I want to welcome everybody back to the channel. And if you're a new subscriber, thank you so much for that. And if you're a brand new viewer, welcome. Thank you for joining me. And hopefully you find something here that's informative or useful. This video is a three-part series on making a wire armature tree. This is the first part. And yes, that means video-wise, I'm taking a break from the sharebang. And the reason is I shot this video intended just for my patrons. And along the way, I discovered that I had a lot of problems with this tree. And I will not explain any of them here. They're explained very thoroughly in the video. And that was not the kind of video I wanted to put up for my patrons. So I decided to take it and put it out as a viewable for everybody on the channel. And hopefully help you to understand how I learn and how I make mistakes. And I think that process is valuable. And a lot of people feel that I can be self-critical or, you know, I overanalyze myself or, you know, but if I sound self-deprecating in the video, I'm not. I learned a ton from this experience. I enjoyed it mostly. There's some struggles in there. And I feel like there were some lessons that I thought you could take away from it and maybe enjoy the process that I went through seeing it happen. So advice that I give, I should take myself. Lesson number one, I didn't take my own advice. It hurt me. Lesson two was plan. Problems showed up at the end and I could have anticipated those at the beginning. These only showed up when I was applying the bark and that's too late to fix some things. So planning ahead. And using unconventional methods to try to do something. Sometimes that's great, and sometimes you really get something better out of it, and sometimes you don't. So, you know, straying out on your own path can cause problems, but that's okay. That's part of the learning process. And so I think of this as a long-form, rapid-fire critique for myself. And with that out of the way, just a quick couple of comments about the technical issues during the video. I shot this video series before I shot the wheel videos, and so I was trying to save a little time, and I took a couple shortcuts, and those did not work out so well. So there's a couple spots where I didn't turn on the mic, so the audio's kind of terrible. I now record redundantly in case I forget to turn on one, I've got the other. The focus in a couple spots is pretty bad, and that's because I did not reset the focus when I turned off the camera and turned it back on, so the focus drifted. I didn't think it would drift that much. It does, and I have some color issues because I thought I'd use the average white balance on the camera, and lo and behold, that drifts depending on what is in the frame. It adjusts along the way. I did not know that, so I need to shoot a gray card and set the custom white balance, so if you are a video maker, that's a tip for you. Shoot a gray card, get your custom white locked down. And there are not as many close-ups or any really good close-ups in this video. And that's a big disappointment for me. And that is why I have added a third camera. Thank you, patrons. Thank you. This stuff doesn't happen without you. So thank you. And you will see that third camera come into play at the very end of the third video. And that's when it arrived, and that's when I started using it. So forgive some of the lack of details. I have tried to zoom in on things to help you see them better, but the technical issues I had were lessons that I learned, again. And you saw some of them corrected in the wheel video that was the wheel videos that were just before this. And despite all the problems, I am going to finish the tree. I think it's going to look pretty cool when it's done. It's just not the tree that I wanted. And it's not the technique that should be used because that added a lot of time to making it that was very unnecessary. Hopefully you'll enjoy seeing this process and seeing these videos. And while you are viewing them, I will be working on the sharebang. I'm very excited about it. And I've been itching to work on it. So at the end of this series, we will be jumping right back in and I will have a lot of work by then, hopefully, done on it. So let's go back in time and see how this wire armature tree was made. So when making a wire armature tree, which is what this project is going to be, it is helpful to have multiple wire gauges to wrap the branches. It's not necessary to have all of these or even these exact ones. This is 28 gauge, 26, 24, 22, and 18. So when I cut these, I tend to cut them to about the height of the tree that I want. When I cut the wire, I'm gonna cut it about yay length. Cutting hundreds of strips like this, pulling out each one at a time is very time consuming, so I find it's helpful to wrap the wire around two posts, and then I can cut sections of it. So let me show you what that looks like. And then, once I have all my wires cut, I take one strand and I wrap it around the group so that it keeps them from flying all over the place. Plus, it makes it easy to pull one out. Excuse my blood blister, that was from working with some wood and hitting my finger. Anyway, so this is how I store the wire while I'm working on it. I am going to start with, for this one, this is the 22 gauge. So we tend to work from the top of the tree down. So this is going to be an upper branch. And let's take a couple 26s. And I begin twisting them. So I try to twist them tight. It's not critical. And we don't need to twist the whole length. In fact, we really probably don't want to at this point. And then, let's see here. So, I'll do that just a little bit more here. And so, I begin twisting it along one of those top branches. So I've got my three pieces here. And one thing I've found in previous work is that when I start to have a very protruding wrap, right? So this wrap isn't quite along the branch. It's more of a tighter spiral. It creates a texture that becomes a little more tricky to fill once we go in with the bark. So we can try to make the wraps a little bit more along the length rather than such a tight spiral. So as I come down this, I don't want a tight spiral, meaning the loops are very close to each other. I want a gradual spiral. I'm going to bend that out a little bit more so I can keep track of it. If you can see, in here, there's a little bit, it's starting to gap a little bit. And you can see that texture. So I have not tried to do this before with pliers, but we're gonna see if we can just tighten that up. So let's try it like this. So I'm gonna pull and twist. Pull. So something like that. And that looks really, really nice. That's a nice, see how the texture is even all the way across? So because we're working from the top of the tree down, you can start with the longer pieces of wire, because there are bumps in it from wrapping it and coming off of the spool. I'm just gonna give that a little tighten, smooth that out. But I want to come in with the thick wires first, just to start filling up the branch, because getting some thickness here takes quite a bit of wire. So I want to use heavier gauge wires wherever possible. Do that. So I'm going to bend it out a little bit so I can keep track of that, since I've been having a little trouble with that. And it'll even start, feels like, starting to fit the groove. This is better than I've done in the past, so that's what I say. I'm learning as I go. Need every piece of wire to go all the way to the end, because we're going to be very likely cutting some of this off, and of course other branches are going to join this and thicken it up, so otherwise we'll end up with a trunk that's ginormous, so we don't want that. So don't worry about whether the individual branch wires go all the way to the end. I tend to notice past experiences that I don't really need super fine tips, because they tend to be a little obscured by the foliage, which is fine, and that can depend quite a bit on the foliage that you use. But I do like to have some smaller ones. I'd rather have too many small ones than too many large ones. Start it at the base just so I get an easier grab, and then I can come around. So we end up with something like that. Let's finish this around. So we'll call that one done for a second, and let's make another one. We'll make one a little smaller than this. So we have our two branches, so let's join them. One of the things I wanted to mention, re-emphasize, is that if you notice, I made this wrapping much shorter than this one. If I wrap this all the way down and I twist them, I have two large cables twisting, and that makes another difficult texture that you have to fill with the bark to hide that cable look. So I've left this relatively exposed so that if I join them at that point, making this branch just this long, I'm going to move it down a little bit. Actually, I'm not going to move it down too much. Let's not do that. Okay. And then I can take these loose coils, these loose strands, I mean, that gives you an idea of where we're at. this looks really nice compared to work I've done in the past. There's still a little, some irregularities in there, but there's going to be, and some of that works for the branch having various, you know, texture, shape, I should say. However, where it looks cabled, it's going to be cabled looking under the bark unless we fill it in. So there's some areas here, but I think it's going to be all right. So we're going to set this aside. Now, when I'm working on the tree, even though I like to see all the branches, they become a bit of a problem to work with. So I'm going to push them all together here. And that way I have less things in the way when I twist other branches. All right, so we'll set that aside. Let's work on another one. So I thought it'd be interesting to add another small branch here and show a slightly different way of doing it. I'm not sure of the exact height the tree is gonna be, but I feel like this branch might be a little long. So what I did is I wired up a sort of small branch. And I'm going to add it right about here. And one of the things that I often find is tricky is the where branches meet, it creates a bit of a cabled look. And so I'm inserting it where the untwisted area is so that I can make those freely wrap individually. What I've been trying this time around when making this tree is to wrap the coils a little tighter at the bottom so that I build up the diameter of the bottom a little bit more quickly. But we'll take a look at another way to do that in a second. I am finding that doing a little twisting with the pliers is really helpful for getting everything in a much tighter spiral. And while I mentioned that, overstressing the metal through twisting is likely to cause metal fatigue and maybe break, the nice thing is that you can just unwind a little bit and make the branch shorter. And I've done a couple other branches already. And this one I've done as a shorter branch to come off of a little lower in the trunk. And I realize that these feel a little bit long. I'm going to leave them long because, again, I can always go back and trim these to a smaller length quite easily. I'll tell you what, let's add a little something there. So I'm selecting shorter pieces for this since it'll be a little shorter down on the trunk. Because of this spiral right here, I'd like to use this piece as a way to kind of smooth that out if I can. So I'm going to try to come across in the middle of the twist, but they seem to, well, they kind of want to line up on their own anyway. But that should help it a little bit. I'll give that a little tighten and we'll see how that looks. I do think sometimes I take a wire that is unnecessarily small in gauge to do some work, and I think I might make faster progress sometimes with skipping some of the thinner gauges. So see how I've kind of getting a little bit in between those wraps to kind of even it out a little bit. Now, of course, it's easier to finish all these pieces before, say, working on this branch, make it easier to twist, but I can't see that far into the future when I'm working on a tree. To me, it's just sort of an organic process. I work on a bit, and then I look at a spot, and I think, I don't know, that branch needs a little more. And again, now I can look to see where there are troughs, and I can run that wire through the trough to try to even out that overall branch area. This is Soof. He likes wire. Which can make working on trees more challenging. I'm gonna make another branch, and then we're gonna come back and we'll start putting these together to form the rest of the tree. So off camera, I built another one. And for this one, this was actually a little experiment. I decided to use the heavy gauge as the core for it to build up some thickness more quickly. And I have mixed opinions about it, but just to give you an example of what that might look like. So combining these, let's put these together. So I wanted to kind of get a sense of how this might look, because I want to start from the top and move my way down. And now that I've got this large core in here, I'll be honest, I don't want to try to mess with that one too much. All right, so I'm gonna do something like this. So this is gonna be my second height, and this will be my lowest, and this will be my highest. So now, the way I've done this in the past, I have not been happy with. So we are going to see if taking a little more care at this point in the process makes the effect a little bit better. So let's see here. So I'm going to splay these out a little bit, give myself some room, and let's do this right here. How about that? So I hope you enjoyed this video, seeing a little bit about how I work and sometimes the struggles that I have, as anybody does. And questions and comments are always welcome down below. I've been working on catching up on comments. Talk about that later. But I'm not going to give you any more thoughts on the tree, because there are other segments and those thoughts are in those next videos. So I hope you come back to see those videos and my thoughts on them, because you know that I will be back soon with another Terranscapes video.